Infections and sepsis are very dangerous for newborns, particularly for newborns with low gestational age and low birth weight. They are dangerous because they can be lethal and also provoke some damages, also transforming into disabilities, permanent disabilities. So it's a great job for neonatologists to treat precociously and efficaciously infections and sepsis. Fortunately, we have antibiotics that have changed the destiny of these newborns with sepsis and with infections. Most of them are related to the permanence in the neonatal intensive care unit, so are nosocomial bacteria that cause these infections. Antibiotics must be used in appropriate way. At the beginning of the sign, also before to have culture showing which strain is responsible for the infections. And we must use also antibiotics from gram-positive and gram-negative, because sometimes the nosocomial agents may be very, very, very difficult to treat and also resistant to most of antibiotics. We now have some strains that are very, very dangerous and newly recognized. I'm speaking about the MRSA, the methicillin-resistant staphylococci, or also the some strains of Klebsiella that can be also responsible for a high number of deaths, particularly in premature babies, if we do not treat in an adequate way. So the job of the neonatologist is very, very hard. Each neonatologist must be an infectious disease specialist for their newborns. And this is important to know, and also the network that may be activated between among neonatologists, also the microbiologists, and all those that are involved in the health of newborns. Neonatal intensive care has changed the destiny of newborns with low gestational age. Now we have a survival of exceeding 95% in newborns with birth weight under 1 kilogram and half. And this is a great victory, a great goal for all neonatologists. Antibiotics share this victory with neonatologists, and the research might be go in and towards new goals, new strategies, and new results.